we're going to do this exactly right. Just like the professional television people.
That we are.
Yes.
Who else? Yes. Who else is calling in? Good morning, callers.
Okay, now, I think you're probably about ready to...
Hey, guess what time it is? It's 7:45. Hey, everybody, welcome to Morning Song, brought to you by the John C. Campbell Folk School. We are recording this or performing this down in Atlanta, Georgia, where Geoff and I both live, and we've got a few things for you, and hope you enjoy this. So let's start. Let's sing one together. How about "I'll Fly Away"? Singing through your iPhone, Geoff.
Yeah, that was incredible.
I'll tell well, how you. How are you doing after that? Are you wide awake now?
Yeah, I'm awake. Wearing this mask, it's fogging up my eyes, but hopefully.
You can just take those glasses off. You can't hear. Now just take the glasses
off.
Yeah,
I'm half blind, deaf. I'm a regular Helen Keller. Okay. So let's
All right, well, let's play another song.
Where's the delete button? Yeah.
All right, so we're going to do one called Going Down That Road Feeling Bad. It was made popular by Woody Guthrie, and we know it as a bluegrass instrumental called Lonesome Road Blues, right?
Written that by is correct. Brooks.
And Geoff's going to kick that off with a nice brisk Captain. Tempo.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm going down the road feeling bad. All right. Hey, we're going to switch things up just a little bit here. Geoff's going to play an instrumental that was written by Bill Monroe. And for this one, we need the gold-plated banjo. And
yeah. Well, instead of sitting here tuning for 10 years, I just carry two banjos, you know? And as you know, this banjo players spend half their time tuning and the other half of their time playing out of tune, so...
Hey, since I'm not singing, I'm going to go with the mask now.
Oh, okay. That's good. So now we're both look ridiculous.
Here we go. I hope everybody's being safe out there, okay? We're almost socially distant, but we have been wearing masks a lot if we've been getting ready for this, and I hope everybody's doing the same or trying to. So here's that instrumental by Bill Monroe. This is called Jerusalem Ridge. This is a song called I've Just Seen a Face on their great record, they're all great, Rubber Soul. And there was no banjo on the original recording, but I'm guessing that if there had been, it would have been Ringo.
Yeah. All right, okay.
All right, are you ready? One, two, three, four. I've just seen a face, I can't forget the time, the place we just met you, just the girl. Yes, sir. Grab the guitar, we'll play a guitar tune.
Oh, okay.
Or song.
Okay.
So we've got a bit more here for you, and we just want to let you guys know that that we started working with the John C. Campbell Folk School in 2001. Geoff had spoken to the school about teaching. And you went up and assisted a class, and then that went very well, and you were offered a beginning banjo class. And
almost killed me. It was during Little Kids Week. I'm serious. We had classes that started, and there was no break, and all these kids would come in. But
that was really good for you, right?
Oh yeah. No, it was the start of a really good fun thing, and I think everybody's had fun. The students have always had fun. We've laughed a lot. We even had a student one time that came because she was walking by the music room, and there's so much laughter going on that she signed up for the next class.
Awesome. So Geoff, you know, Geoff was given this first class, and it filled up very quickly, and he needed an assistant, so you invited me to come and assist. And I'd actually heard of the school before then as well. My wife had been up to take some classes in knitting, with Martha Owen, and our kids had been up for a little middle, and they might have actually been in one of your classes, Geoff, and somehow they survived that.
Oh, the kids' class.
Yeah.
And they were the only two behaved kids in the whole class.
But anyway, we've been lucky enough to work with the folk school since 2001, and like Geoff said, I mean, it's been a fantastic experience. The folk school has always just been a wonderful respite from all the crazy stuff that's going on in the world. And even in the midst of everything that we're experiencing right now, it's really nice that the folk school is continuing the Morningsong tradition. When you're finished watching our Morningsong today and you're still looking at your Facebook page, I think if you'll go down the page a little bit, there's a comment section, and there's actually a place there where you might be able to make a contribution to the folk school. So
Wow. If
you're so inspired, consider doing that. I know the folk school would really appreciate it. And anyway, we're just really grateful to have the chance to do this for you today.
If you're paying by check, just make it out to Rick Taylor and Geoff Hohwald. No, I'm just
kidding. I'm sure the folk school would appreciate that.
No, I think it's a testament to the feeling and the great support of the folk school family that they've been shut down now, probably going to be about 9 months.
That's right.
And that there's been a lot of giving and support, and that has enabled the folk school to continue doing their great work. And I noticed this is the 95th year, so 5 years from now it's going to be 100 years.
It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. We're awfully fortunate to have it in the world. And thank you guys for being here. Let's do another one. This is This is a folk tune, folk song that was written a while back by a Canadian writer named Ian Tyson. And he had a duo with his wife Sylvia, and this was one of the songs they did. It's called Four Strong Winds. Think I'll head out to Alberta. Weather's good there in the fall. Got some friends that I can go working for. Still, I wish you'd change your mind. If I'd ask you one more time, but we've been through this a hundred times or more. Four strong winds that blow lonely, seven seas. If I get there before the snow flies, and if things are looking good, you could meet me if I send you down there. But by then it would be winter, not too much for you to do.
Oh, well, thank you. Actually, it was all Rick's fabulous singing that pulled that one off.
Well,
rugged good looks, anyway.
Hey, how about another banjo song, banjo
okay.
tune?
All okay, all right, let's do it.
Let's do that.
And
we'd like to do one, this is another one that comes from the canon of great Flatten Scruggs, Lester Flatten Earl Scruggs songs. And I believe that Lester Flatt's given the songwriting credit on this. And it's called Little Cabin Home on the Hill. And we're going to get Geoff all set up here. We'll be back.
I'm ready.
He's ready. Little Cabin Home on the Hill. Sit alone and cry in our Do you want to tell the mask comes off, people? Here
now,
it is.
Now, you need to put yours on.
I'm
going to
put mine on. I'm going to sing through the mask.
Yes, we're doing social distancing here. Yeah, I wish we'd started this mask thing a long time ago.
Nothing says social distancing like the banjo.
Yes, that's it. That'll promote some social distancing. Okay. So, all right, here we go.
Okay, you want to tell them about the song?
Well, basically, you know, back before all the TV and the sports networks and everything else, people would get bored way out in the country. So, you know, Junior's sitting there and real bored. And Ma says, Junior, why don't you go outside and imitate animal sounds on your instrument? Anyway, so we're going to imitate the sound of a mule ran on the banjo.
And then, what about your singing? You're going to sing on this.
Yeah, this is, so you may want to hit your mute button here. Okay, here we go.
All right, here we go. Time for one or two more?
Well, we could do two more.
Let's do two more.
Because people aren't going to
I don't think they're going to go anywhere. We're
cafeteria,
not going anywhere. That's right.
Dining room.
Okay. And, you know, you can just wait another few minutes before you have that breakfast. You want to grab the guitar and let's do...
Okay.
Let's do The Last Thing on My Mind. How about that?
And okay.
That'll be...
key of A.
That's
okay.
Right. That's right.
All right. Let's see. Oh, I even have a...
You probably have a guitar already.
There we go. Hopefully it's in tune.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let me get down the key of that.
Yeah, that would be nice. All right. Oh, let's get back to the mask.
That's
thing,
right. Yeah. Put your mask on.
Okay.
A great song, a great folk song written by Tom Paxton. And he is out there touring after all this time. He started his career in the 60s, and he's still going strong. Yeah. Doing great.
Man, still alive. That's amazing. No, seriously.
Okay. The Last Thing on My Mind. It's a lesson. Mighty fine, Geoff. That was great. Guys, thank you again for being here with us for Morning Song today. Once again, Geoff Hohwald here, getting some banjo picks ready. I'm Rick Taylor, and we're just so thankful to the John C. Campbell Folk School for keeping the Morning Song tradition going through the difficulties of the pandemic, and appreciate you guys being here with us and being a part of it. We're going to do one more thing for you. Back to Flat and Scruggs for a minute. One of the signature banjo pieces written by Earl Scruggs.
All right.
And became the theme song for the movie Bonnie and Clyde.
Right. That's true.
And it is the instrumental Foggy Mountain Breakdown.
That is that. And just to remind people, if you want to make a contribution.
Right. Further down the page, I believe, what you're looking at on your screen is a comment button or comment tab that you can touch or punch, and that will get you to a place where I think you can make a contribution to the Folk School if you'd like to. So this has been great. Geoff, thank you.
Well, thank you, Rick. It's been fun. We practiced a lot for this just to...
I know. We're almost back in shape. A little rusty, right. But... good to be here.
Ready.
Yeah, the Foggy Mountain Breakdown.
Now remember, there's two gears
just
and overdrive.
Okay, all right.
I'm giving away the secret here.
Have a great day, and we'll see you next time. Take care.